Hello and welcome to this video about specific safety measures on the AC side for electrical installations with photovoltaic production. In buildings where photovoltaic production is used for self-consumption, the photovoltaic system is an integral part of the electrical installation. In this video, I will explain some of the main specific safety measures required on the AC side for such installations. Loss of mains protection, location of overcurrent protection, and isolation and switching of the photovoltaic supply system. Loss of mains protection is required by grid codes and by energy distributors for installations with photovoltaic self-consumption. This protection guarantees that in case of utility supply outage, the installation will not energize the distribution network, which could compromise safety of utility workers. Loss of mains protection can be implemented by a dedicated protection device, generally located at the photovoltaic system feeder. Another option is to use grid-tie photovoltaic inverters with integrated loss of mains protection if it's accepted by the energy distributor. Check the solar inverter datasheet to confirm it includes loss of mains protection and to verify appropriate standards compliance. Another safety measure is AC overcurrent protection for the photovoltaic power supply system. To isolate electrical faults on the photovoltaic installation, an overcurrent protection device must be located at the point where the photovoltaic system is connected to the building's electrical installation. It's essential to include the overcurrent protection in this exact location to avoid tripping of the main circuit breaker in case of fault in the photovoltaic feeder. To ensure things work properly, this overcurrent protection should be coordinated with the main circuit breaker to guarantee selectivity. This selectivity may not be so easy to achieve, in particular when the photovoltaic production capacity is equivalent to or higher than the building installed power. In this case, the circuit breaker at the photovoltaic incomer has the same rating or higher than the main circuit breaker, as shown in this example. Thus, to ensure selectivity between the two breakers, you may oversize the main circuit breaker, or split the photovoltaic system into smaller systems, or consider time selectivity for applications higher than 630 amps. Now, let's consider the isolation and switching of the photovoltaic power supply system. First, an AC disconnection device must be located at the photovoltaic switchboard to isolate photovoltaic system from the rest of the electrical installation during maintenance. Next, an isolation function must be provided for the photovoltaic inverters by disconnection means on both DC side and the AC side. To sum up, certain specific safety measures are required on the AC side of installations with photovoltaic production, including loss of mains protection, overcurrent protection for the photovoltaic power supply system, which must be located on the building busbar side, and AC isolation and switching for the photovoltaic system. In our next videos, I will cover additional protection measures, such as surge protection, residual current devices selection, or specific protection requirements for installations operating both grid-connected and off-grid. Thank you for watching. Feel free to share and see you soon.